science instruments, where we explore the fascinating world of science. I'm Dr. Hannah Lacy, and today we're going to dive back into the realm of electrospinning and talk about a crucial concept in this process, the Taylor cone. But before we start, make sure you've subscribed and hit that notification bell so you never miss an update from us. All right, grab your lab coats, safety glasses, and let's jump right in.
As you may have seen from our previous videos, electrospinning is a unique and incredibly versatile technique used in a wide range of applications, from producing nanofibers for textiles to creating drug delivery systems. At its core, it's a process where a high voltage is applied to a solution, typically a dissolved polymer, causing it to eject a fine jet of solution. As the solution stream elongates and whips around, the solvent evaporates, and we're left with solidified, ultrafine fibers. Here's a simplified diagram of an electrospinning setup. We have a polymer solution in a syringe, a high voltage source, and a grounded collector. But there's something magical that happens during this process, and that's what we're going to talk about today, the Taylor cone. So what's this Taylor cone I keep mentioning? The Taylor cone, named after the British physicist Sir Geoffrey Taylor, is the conical shape formed at the tip of the polymer solution as it exits the needle. It's like the maestro of electrospinning, and here's why it's so important. When we apply a high voltage to our polymer solution, charges build up along the surface of the solution until the electric forces overcome the surface tension. The liquid at the tip of the needle stretches and elongates, forming this distinct cone shape. This geometry is the key to electrospinning success. So why is the Taylor cone crucial in electrospinning? Let's break it down. First, there's fiber formation. The formation of the Taylor cone is where the electrospinning process begins. From the cone's tip, a jet of polymer solution is ejected, and as it whips and dries, it turns into a solid nanofiber. Next, there's fiber control. The shape of the Taylor cone and the distance between the needle and collector influence the diameter of the resulting nanofibers. By controlling the Taylor cone, we can adjust characteristics of the fibers, like its diameter and morphology. Then, there's uniformity. The Taylor cone stability can be a great indication of the uniformity and consistency of nanofibers being produced. It can also give us an indication of certain electrospinning parameters that may need to be changed or optimized. Scientists and engineers tinker with various parameters like voltage, polymer solution properties, and needle size to control the formation and stability of the Taylor cone. This in turn lets them intentionally alter their process to produce fibers with specific characteristics. For example, a stable and symmetrical cone typically means our process is near optimization and leads to more uniform fibers. However, if we have a receding Taylor cone, we may see drying at the needle tip leading to non-uniform fiber formation, or even no fiber formation due to clogging. In another case, if we have an elongated Taylor cone or dripping, we may see defects in our sample, like drips, holes, and variation in fiber diameter sizes. In both of these cases, we should consider adjusting parameters like flow rate, voltage applied, and working distance, assuming our solution is optimized. For more information on what an optimized solution looks like, be sure to check out our upcoming video on important electrospinning solution parameters. As we've seen, the applications of electrospinning are diverse and far-reaching, from wound dressings with antibacterial properties, to air filtration, to tissue engineering, and more. All of these rely on the formation and control of the Taylor cone to create the desired nanofibers.
So, there you have it, the incredible Taylor cone. A fundamental concept in the world of electrospinning, whose formation and control open the door to a myriad of possibilities in various scientific and industrial fields. If you found this video informative and you enjoy learning about electrospinning, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and share this video with your fellow science enthusiasts. And remember, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Thanks for joining us at Nanoscience Instruments, and until next time, stay curious.